Hey guys, in this video, we are going to simplify the following rational expression. And then after we simplify this rational expression, we are also going to state the restrictions. So let's dive in. One thing we should always do is have directions above a problem. So I'm gonna write simplify and state restrictions. Honestly, it would be better for me to even say, simplify the following rational expression. When you look back at your notes a week later, a month later, a marking period later, in college, a semester later, you want to remember what those things were called, what topic were you on, what section in your book was that. These notes are for you. Remember, think about what notes really are. People take notes when they're reading something so that they remember important pieces of it. I feel like you guys just think this is something my hand does for exercise during class. You gotta get out of that mentality, okay? So this right here is, as we've been discussing, a rational, meaning a ratio, right? Rational or fraction expression. Whenever we want to simplify, anytime you want to simplify, that should make you think factor. And after it helps you think of factoring, that should make you think reduce also. Simplify and reduce, okay? Reduce and simplify are the same thing more or less, okay? So that right there is a quadratic trinomial, and we have another quadratic trinomial. These are kind of nice quadratic trinomials. You don't have to necessarily have all of these details to have this correct, but if you are someone who has a hard time, and if you are, you know, nervous about college one day, you know, it wouldn't hurt you to be really good with the vocab. Know what things are called, so when your professor asks a question, you can use the right terminology, and it gives you a little advantage where you look like you know what you're talking about, even if you're confused, and they can give you the benefit of the doubt. Okay, so a quadratic trinomial, that's standard form, looks something like that. Now these are nice because the a value is 1 in both of them. So if I wanted to factor to get this guy started, we're going to factor to get it started. We're going to end up with a little double bubble, and that is what factors are. Factors multiply to give you this bigger thing over here, this bigger product, okay? So from here, if you wanted to use AC method, A is 1 and C is 25. 1 times 25 obviously is just 25. We get the factors of 25, pairs of factors. So one pair is 1 and 25, and the only other pair is 5 and 5. B for the bottom of the list, and B for but what? But I need a pair that adds to give me 10. Obviously, 10, we can only get that from 5 and 5. Shortcut of factoring with AC method to avoid grouping, if you could handle it, if you can. If A equals 1, shortcut, and the shortcut is basically you take those two numbers and you dive right in, okay? It's going to be positive 5 and positive 5. So we're going to go with x plus 5, x plus 5. You don't necessarily have to do the quad where you split the middle, underline, underline. You need that when A is not 1. But if A is 1, bam, shortcut. If you're going to mess that up, don't do it. If you can handle a shortcut, do it. Next one, the bottom. We'll do that a little faster now, okay? 1 times 20 is 20. AC is 20, A equals 1, we could take the shortcut, 1 and 20, 2 and 10, 3, no, 4 and 5, bottom of the list, has to be 9, I see my pair, 4 and 5, I'm going to take the shortcut, x plus 4 and x plus 5. If you wrote x plus 5 and x plus 4, guess what, same thing, so who cares? Multiplication is commutative. It doesn't matter what order you write it in, okay? Commutative, okay? Like there's a T, commutative, like commute to work, commute to school. Now, we've done the factor phase. Factor first. Now, for an S word, we could say we factor first, Simplify second, you know, because SSFF, get it? What can I simplify or reduce from here? Any matching factor. You cannot reduce from here. You can't be like, I'm gonna cross out x squared and I'm gonna cross out fives from things. You can't do that. No one ever showed you that.
X plus 5.
Thank you. X plus five and another x plus five. Thank you. Good, Jabari. So those are gone. Gonzaroni. Now, what's left is the simplified expression. That would be x plus five and as the numerator and x plus four as the denominator. When those are the only factors left, it's just one factor. You don't need parentheses around it. It's just like multiplication. If you don't have like a dot between the four and the five or the two and the 10, this would look like 210 and 120. You need a dot, you need a parenthesis, something to show the separate factors. But when it's the only factor, you don't need a dot or parentheses. Obviously, we use parentheses when we have two terms in an expression or something like that. Now, yes, that is the simplified answer. We still need to state our restrictions. Restrictions come from the fact that we are not allowed to divide by what number? We are not allowed to divide by.
Zero.
Thank you. Not allowed to divide by zero. This is where it gets sneaky, though. What number will be poisoned and put a zero in the denominator? Because the denominator is what we divide by. So, what number is poison for this problem? X plus four. X marks the spot. You want to plop a number in there. What number, when you plop it in there, makes that denominator zero? X cannot equal X plus four cannot be zero. Subtract four from both sides to find out what X cannot equal. Oops.
Negative four.
Exactly, negative four. Sorry, you guys didn't tell me I was off the screen. Now, if you only put that as your restriction, that would be partial credit for that because we missed one. This restriction is just one of them. Even if you don't see it anymore, even if we crossed it out, it still gets included, okay? So we have to go back also and look at this factor right over here. If anything is ever in a denominator, anything that's ever being divided, that has to be included. So the other one was x plus five. That also cannot equal zero. Minus five, minus five. After we subtract the 5 from both sides, x can't equal negative 5 either. So that's my other restriction. X cannot equal negative 5. Now I'm going to give you some new vocab right now. So even if you did get this all right, you're going to add this detail to your notes because this is some new vocab for us. And the vocab is going to be types of what we call a discontinuity. So I know it's a big word right there. I will spell it out for you guys. But a discontinuity is basically directly related to these restrictions. So it's like, I use the example, like your parents might be like, you could hang out with anybody you want from class except Melvin. Do not hang out with Melvin. Not that Melvin. You know, I hear, you know, Melvin, you know, he likes to watch Law and Order, and that's a very graphic show. I don't want you hanging out with Melvin. Like whatever, I don't know, making up something. So that restriction, it's gonna cause an interruption in your life if you're like in class and doing classwork and you have to go and talk to everyone in class, but you're like, uh-oh, can't talk to Melvin. You're gonna have like an interruption. Or a discontinuity. So it's like, oh, you talk to Natalie, you talk to Saul, you talk to Justin, Jabari, Amelia, and then you're like, Melvin, I can't talk to him. That's a discontinuity. There's a disconnect at that moment. You have to kind of like finagle your way around Melvin and go to the next person. So these are restrictions. Yes, I'm gonna highlight them in yellow. So this would have been the right answer for the homework. But like I said, I'm building on this right now, so you're going to add this to other info to your notes. I will put it underneath, but I want to make sure you guys should be able to see everything more or less still, right? Yeah. Okay. X squared, and I'll circle this whole thing. I'm going to write the whole problem. X squared plus 10x plus 25 over x squared plus 9x plus 20 has, the word is dis, D-I-S, con, C-O-N, tin, T-I-N, dis, con, tin, ooh, eh, tease. Sorry, that one's hard to spell while I write. So U-I-T-I-E-S. So that rational expression has discontinuities at x equals negative 4, and I don't want to get cut off on the screen, sorry, x equals negative 5. So I just wrote it as a full sentence. So I didn't write can't equal because I'm like just describing where those discontinuities are. So here's the rational expression. It is continuous everywhere except at negative 4 for x and negative 5. Now, we can describe the type of discontinuity, okay? So we can talk about, let's say Dylan loves dessert. Well, what type of dessert does Dylan love? Dylan, do you like a dessert? Is there a dessert you do like? What type of dessert? Dessert is like a very vague term. Maybe Dylan likes ice cream, cookies, cake, I don't know, cupcakes, something like that. So, types of discontinuities. I'm going to show you two words right now. The one that we crossed out, okay? We reduced it, right? We got rid of it. Since we got rid of it, I'm going to highlight this in purple so we associate it with that other purple right there. That one is known as a removable discontinuity. Okay, so I'm going to slide up a little bit more so you can see a little bit better. That one is known as a removable. We move. See, I always mess this up if I drop the E or not. One day in life, I'm going to remember. I think the E stays. Yeah. Remove. Guys, next time I ask you, is there an E? Do I drop the E or keep it? You're going to tell me. You looked it up. You keep the E. Removable discontinuity. Now, the other one does not remove. It's still there. It's even in the final answer right here, right? It's a part of that final answer. I'm going to just go over here with my green highlighter. That was my simplified answer. Simplify. Simplify. That was it right there, okay? So I'll go over that one in green because it's still there as well. Now, we have two names for it. The first name is pretty silly, but it's just non-removable. So that's a name. But there are two types of non-removable discontinuities. So it's like a flow chart. Like we could keep getting more specific, okay? So next, after non-removable, the type that we're going to talk about right now is if it's always there, we can't reduce it. Okay? Just trying to make associations to help you remember. It's there forever. Okay? Always and always, forever and ever. It's called an infinite discontinuity. Infinite. Finite. Finite is something that ends or stops or terminates. Okay, a finite list of numbers is like a list of numbers that doesn't go on forever. Infinite is not finite. Infinite, discontinuity. Okay, I left that parenthesis off. There is another type that's called jump discontinuity, but we'll save that for a future day. Future lesson. Okay, so does everyone have that new note down? So we went from our original problem, we factored, we reduced, we got our simplified answer. We stated our restrictions. We had two restrictions. One came from even in simplified form, it was still there. But the other, we didn't forget, was the one that we did cross out. It's right there. But today, bonus, we added on some more vocab where we specified types of discontinuities. So this is an add-on. So just because this was a homework example doesn't mean we can't add some lesson to it. So that right there is part of the new lesson. And let me see. So Paige, you have a question about this?
I just have a, like, I'm still confused in, like, the non-removable and the removable.
So at first, we're going to think of the removable as being, like, it's a discontinuity, as in it's a number that causes an interruption to our expression. Everything's all fine and dandy in our expression until we hit -4 or until we hit -5. Every other number, we're good. Easy breezy, smooth sailing. Everything's fine. But then all of a sudden we have these numbers that are bad news, right? They cause the bottom to be 0. We're not allowed to divide by 0. Oh no, alarms are going off. My problem was poisoned. We got to fix it. Now, removable, just think, like, can you remove the problem by factoring and reducing? Can you remove it? Yes, we removed it right there. Boom, gone. Removed. So it's removable from our site. And non-removable, we can't remove it. Then later, when we graph things like this, we're going to compare the names of these to how they affect the graph of that equation when we make it y equals that. And that'll be a later portion of this, okay? So we are going to continue building on it, but we just want to get the vocab down first. Any other questions before I end the video and I move to the next one?
Sorry. So it's like X plus 5 can reduce.
Yeah. We don't want to say cancel because that makes 0. It reduces. So it goes away. It gets removed because it equals 1 because it's X plus 5 over X plus 5. Maybe I could have reduced it with that X plus 5. It doesn't matter. I don't know what made me do it diagonally like that, but all good. And that makes it a removable discontinuity. So when we do the next example, we'll see. We'll practice this on the homework of the next one, and we'll see if we kind of get the hang of it. All right?
Yeah.
All right. Any other questions before I move on? 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. So if you are watching the video and you think you got the hang of it, put a thumbs up. If you think I'm crazy and don't know what I'm talking about, put a thumbs down. And we will continue to the next example.